Hey everyone, Sheila here from Life with Pets. So today we are going to be talking about cleaning an aquarium and using this Python siphon. This is the one that we get asked about all the time, and it's the one that we use to clean our tanks with sand, and it doesn't suck the sand up. We do get a lot of questions on how do we clean the tanks with sand and not lose a lot of it through the siphon. So I'm going to show you how we start the siphon, and then obviously I'm going to show you it working. I will leave a link to it in the description box below. We have just recently started selling these because we were getting asked for them so much that we decided that we would get them in stock and put them on our website. So that link will be in the description box below. So today I am going to do it in a divided tank. These are amazing for divided tanks because the siphon portion of it is not too long, so it can actually fit in each section of the tank. So let's go to our 10 gallon and we'll start cleaning it, and I will show you the whole process of using it and just how great it is. Okay, so I have the siphon and I am going to show it from several different angles so that hopefully you can see just how this is working. I have moved a lot of the frog bit off the top of the tank, so that will help make it easier. But basically all you're going to do is put it into the tank, and then you're going to then hold it up. It needs to be held up. Now, because of the angle that I'm working at, I do usually end up with a kink in it. Obviously that is not going to work. However, I can then just do the kink, put it back in, let it go down again, in, and then that's it now flowing through the tube. And then obviously you need it keeping pointing down. I will do that again from a view underneath so that you can see that as well. So from a below water angle, you're going to put it in, then you're going to lift it up, raise it up so the water can run down, plunge it back in, and then tilt it down towards the substrate, and that should get it going just fine. So what I do like about this siphon is it is so easy to use, and with it being so much smaller, it can really get into those hard to reach places, whether it's in between the wood and glass, whether it's under rocks. You can sort of like move rocks out of the way so that you're able to get in with it, and do find that it's so easy to use, and obviously it does do a really good job. Now the thing, when you do have sand in a tank, you do need to remember that it does need to be disturbed on a regular basis. I do it once a week when I do the water change. Sometimes I do go up to 2 weeks in this tank before I do a water change, and that's simply because it's very heavily planted, but I will always disturb the sand every time I do it, and that is so that you don't get any gas pockets build up. Normally you would not need to do this in a planted tank because the nutrients that are actually in your gravel or in your substrate will feed the plants, but because with sand it has to be disturbed, then I do like to go through and sort of clean it all up. So to then move to the other side, you don't actually need to pull the siphon out. All you need to do is put your hand over the end of it, lift it out, and it will keep the suction, and then put it in the other side, and then it will just keep running. This siphon is good in tanks up to 10 gallons, I would say undivided. We do actually also use it in our 20 gallon as well. It is great for 20 gallon divided tanks, and it is certainly great for 10 gallon divided tanks. So I would say generally this is great for up to 20 gallons, especially if you're wanting to get in some hard to reach places, or if you just don't want your substrate being sucked up with all the water. I would definitely recommend it, especially for divided tanks. Thank you. So all I've got left to do now is put the frog bit back in the tank, but I just wanted to show you, look at the, I can do this one-handed, they've all got mixed up, but just look at the roots on this. How amazing is that? Which is great for betta fish because they love, I can't even get the roots in, but they actually love to sit on them and sort of rest in them. Sometimes if they do get way too long, I mean, look at this one. If they do get way too long, then, gosh, I think that's the longest one we've ever had. Look at that. Yeah, sometimes if they do get too long, then I will actually trim them off, but we usually have sold it by that point, so I don't have to worry about it too much. But sometimes I will go through and just cut. Here's another one, just look at the roots on that. All right guys, I'm gonna finish the tank off and then I will leave you with some footage of how it looks once it's all finished. Okay guys, I was gonna leave you with some footage on how all this looked when it was finished, which is what you're watching now, but I just wanted to apologize for the audio that was coming and going when I had filmed this video, which took me about an hour to do, or an hour and a half to do, and then obviously there's all the editing. When I came to edit it, I realized that there had been a problem with the audio and that it was basically sounded like I was in an echo tunnel. It was just awful. So the parts that were okay, I did leave in, and the other parts I have had to voice over. So I just wanted to apologize for the very, very choppy audio on this video. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Please don't judge me by this one video. If you're new here, check out some of the others. And if you like what you see, go ahead and subscribe, and we will see you in our next video.